Hello all. In this session, we'll discuss about the fundamental concepts of database. Well, so database, the term data and the base. So it's like what exactly data is all about. So developers who are already in computer background or even non-computer background. So everyone deals about data, but they may not call it as data, but everyone deals about data. Like writing some information in the notebook is a data, writing your numbers in the phone is a data, creating a contact in the phone is a data. So knowing or unknowingly, like everyone deals with data. So in computer terminology, or maybe, you know, like in general computer terminology, what exactly we call it as, like a storage of information in computer, right? Like a, now let us say if you want to write a document in the computer, you need to type some set of characters and store it. So whatever you write it, that's called data. So data is nothing but a set of characters or raw facts, we generally call it as. So in computer terminology, we generally call it as a set of characters. So we know that computer stores the information, or computer stores, whatever you write it, it stores in bits, right? It stores in bits kind of format. So now, like, let's get into a little bit more. You know, like a database is all about storage of data. It's not only just storage of data, and it also deals about efficient retrieval of data. So let's understand how exactly data gets stored in the database and what are the various aspects of database a little bit more, right? So like when you create data now, let's say like if you consider your phone, right? When you create any of the data, it gets stored in the set of memory or a chip, whatever you call it as. So there are different kinds of hardware devices which stores data. Generally, if you consider the laptop or a computer or a desktop, so data generally gets stored in the hardware, right? Nothing but hard disk, we call it as. So heart is a place where the data gets stored. If you consider the human brain, the data gets stored in the brain, because brain is a you know, a kind of an organ which is capable enough to store the data, right? So generally, like in computer, data gets stored in the hard disk. And if you consider the, you know, like the mobile phone, generally they have a concept called EPROM concept, which data gets stored in that particular flash chip. Now, so just now we just understood, like, you know, data is nothing but a raw fact. But what is database? What is the need of database? So generally, if you consider any other computer application, you have a huge amount of content or data to be stored. So storage is not a problem. You know, like when you have, let us say if you consider your C drive, let's consider that your Windows operating system, you have a folder called C drive, in that you want to store 1 lakh records. Yes, you can store it. Size is not an issue. Storage is not an issue. But now the issue is, let us say I want to get all the files which were created on 1st January. How do you filter it? You want to find out the list of all the files which are greater than 1 MB. How do you get it? Let us say I want to delete all the files which are created on 1st February. So now that is where the database comes into picture. Database is not only for the purpose of storage. It also deals about efficient manipulation, efficient deletion, efficient retrieval also. Now, here in this particular picture, if you observe, this is one of the example of a table called employees. So this employees, if you observe this employees, right? So the table name is employees, we call it as. This employees is having a set of records and columns. If you're already familiar with Excel sheet, if you have a background of Microsoft Excel, you just consider this as an Excel sheet with a list of rows and columns. So now here the highlighted one, like a 109 employee number, Daniel Faviet is the last name, email D Faviet, and his phone number, right? So if you observe this highlighted one, it's called a record. A record is a set of columns, right? And each column, here if you observe, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 columns. I have 10 records, right? Horizontal rows and vertical columns. So horizontal one, we generally call it as rows, and the vertical one, we generally call it as columns. So a table always contains a set of records and a set of columns. Each record will have a values for a set of columns. Okay. So in database, the only storage component which stores the data is table. Table is the only object in the database which is capable enough to store the data. Okay. Now, so database, is it owned by any company or is it a software? Database is a software. First of all, the basic thing is database is a software, and it is owned by whom? So database is kind of a concept, right? It is a generic software there are many vendors who are designing a product in database area. So Oracle is a predominantly the world number one database. Coming after Oracle, like we have Microsoft, Amazon, and MySQL, Teradata, IBM. There are a lot number of vendors who are providing different types of databases. Now in the databases, again, you have different set of flavors. Like you generally come across RDBMS, columnar database, network database, graphical database. There are a lot number of databases will come into picture, but don't get confused at this point of time. So as at this point of time, understand that database is a software which is capable enough to store as well as retrieve in a very efficient manner. Nothing but that is why it is called database management software, DBMS. The database generally we also call it as database management system. So it's a system which manages the data in a very, very efficient manner. Okay. So how do you manage the data? So that is where the language comes into picture called SQL query. SQL query, you call it a structured query language. The structured query language is a programming language which a database can understand, which we use it for the purpose of managing the data. Okay. So now if you consider maybe if you have any programming background, we know that using C language, I can create a file, I can read a file, I can write a file, I can perform n number of operations on a file. So now in the database, to store the data or to retrieve the data or to manage the data, I require some sort of commands, right? Because it's a software, it performs the operation based on some set of commands which you provide on it. So how do you provide those commands? Using a language called SQL. Structured query language. So this SQL language is not only from Oracle. Whoever the vendor of database, they have their own SQL. So set of commands will be similar, but there are some set of commands which are very much different from from vendor to vendor. Nothing but the command which works in in Microsoft may not work in Oracle database. The command which works in Amazon database may not work in the IBM database. They have some specified set of different commands. But there are some generic commands which works across all the databases. But the concept is same, but the way they store it, the way they retrieve it, the set of commands which are there in each particular database differs. And other thing, so far we just understood, we just saw an example of employee database, employee table, which is having set of rows and columns. But in real world, if you consider after the evolution of the social networking platforms, after the evolution of big data, the data generally got divided into these three things. Structured data, unstructured data, as well as this hybrid data. So structured data is all about where you have a set of rows and columns in a proper manner. You can easily understand that you have the data will have an appropriate structure. So that's all about structure. Nothing but now employee record will always have 5 columns. It's not that one employee will have three columns and one other employee will have 4 columns kind of thing. That will not happen in the structured data. Coming to unstructured data, it's totally data is not at all structured. I mean to say, you have a tweet. One tweet may have 5, five responses. Another tweet may have 25 responses, or it may have digital content, or you may have a different set of diversified data. Nothing but you have analytics, you have a blogs, you have a social likes, you have a registration kind of information, you have a geo a mapping information or a QR code information. So where the data is not at all structured manner, I can say in a very simple terms you don't have a proper rows and columns. One particular record may have 5 columns, another record may have 10 columns kind of thing. That's all about unstructured data. Other one is a hybrid data, it's kind of mix, which has information about, which you get from, IoT devices, hardware devices, which are sensor-based hardware devices, right? Now, one more simple example, I just want to deal about data and databases. If you work on a computer, right? So when you create any file, what will happen? When you create any file and save it, from the operating system perspective, how do you find out your particular file name? Using the location as well as the file name where you are getting stored, that's how you retrieve it. But now, so when operating system is capable enough to store the data, why are we using databases? I think we just now discussed that, using operating system functionality, you cannot manage the data in a very efficient manner. That's where the database coming into picture, right? So now the same concept happens in the database. So, but instead of just creating the file using your normal shortcuts in the database, we use set of commands which are provided by your appropriate database vendor. We generally call it as SQL commands. Using that, we create the data and we perform all the DML operations. Okay. And basically, just now we understood again that database is software. Whatever we create, that gets stored in the database. But how exactly it gets stored, right? So now, like a database is a software, it is having an appropriate functionality or a design architecture which stores the data in a very efficient manner. But it has to store the data in hard disk. Obviously, like whatever you see in the system, it has to be available in the hard disk, and where your particular software is reading that and it is providing to the user. Now, one example I want to show you here is, like, if you consider, like in my case, I'm just considering Oracle database. So now here I have something called data file. So now this Oracle database software stores the whatever the data which I create in this particular database in a file format. So any database, whichever you consider, they store the data in database files. But this database file is not human readable. This can be read by only your operating system vendor. Nothing but each database vendor may have a different approach of writing it, managing it, right? So this is one of the example of database file. So now here, yeah, this is the one which I was discussing about, database data file. So whatever we, now let us say if I create 1,000 records in a particular table, from a database perspective, I can just simply type a command to get the data. But you can't just find out in which file you have that particular data. Even if you find it, you cannot read it. The reason is it gets stored in a different format. I can say it's like encryption format. Only the database vendor can read it. You cannot read it because it will have its own set of security mechanisms or efficient retrieval mechanisms, which it considers while performing the operations on a particular database table. Okay, now this is where, you know, like the logical as well as physical architectural difference comes into picture in the database. I'm not getting much deeper because I just want to give a very high level overview of database. So now, just now we understood that in a database, whatever you create, the data gets stored in the table. The tables, whatever the content which is available in tables, will get stored in a physical format in nothing but data files. Okay. So the logically, you know, generally like a table is part of a table space. Table space will have a part of segments, extents, Oracle blocks, it goes so on and so forth. Okay. Now, one more simple example I want to tell you. Now, let's say if you're from a Microsoft Excel background, when you open a file, you generally type the data, which will have a set of columns and rows and columns, and you will save the data. So we know that whatever you have written it will be available in that particular XLX file. Similarly, now, whenever I create any table in my database, it will have a set of rows and columns. Whatever I have performed or creation or updation or whatever it is, that particular information will be available in a table which I perform. Here, if you observe, Microsoft Excel is a software which is available on a particular operating system. Database is also a software which is available on an operating system. But the basic difference between a database as well as Microsoft Excel is, in the Microsoft Excel, whatever you created, it will be available only to you, right? Or of course, if you use a SharePoint, anyone can see the particular data. But if you want to store 2 GB of data, your Microsoft Excel will support? No way, simple, right? But, and also, does it support web services? Does it support concurrent execution? So there are different things will come into picture. I just want to give a very simple understanding of how the data gets stored in general using a different set of applications, right? So database is kind of a bigger software, which will have an efficient database management system, and it will have a, you know, like a different concurrency, different, you know, like availability, a lot number of things comes into picture. But just understand that it is kind of a one of the other software which is capable enough to store the data. Okay. So now one more thing, like, when you want to modify the data in your Excel sheet, what do? You just open the file and go to the appropriate cell and update it. Similarly, in Oracle database or any database, generally what we do, if you want to update a particular column or a record or a set of columns, what you do, we have to use a command called update. Assume that if you want to get the data which is available in my a particular table, I have to use a command called select command. If I want to delete a particular record, let us say I want to totally delete a record. So if it is an Excel sheet, what you do is select a record and delete it. If you want to create a record, what you do, just click, you select a particular row and click on insert. It'll insert set of rows, whatever you want to insert, right? I'll just show you a few set of commands, the select, update and delete, insert. So now let us say if I want to extract all the employees which are available in my a particular table. So here what I do is, so select is my command name. And here I have to mention which columns I want to retrieve. I want to retrieve all the columns, so I'll just mention star. And from which table? Nothing but I need to mention what is my source. So I'll mention my table name here, employees. Nothing but like a, let us say you have 1,000 files in your operating system and you want to see the employee data. So you have to obviously find out which particular Excel sheet or which particular document is having the information about employees. Similarly, in my database, I have a large number of set of tables, but I need to find out in which table I have the information about the employees. So that your particular application user or a business user or a database user has to provide, this table is having the information about this particular data. Now I'll just execute this command. So this is providing me the list of records which is having the employee information. Now let us say I want to update this particular employee name, whose employee ID is 251, 256. I'll just say update employees set first name is equal to Z1 underscore new where employee underscore 256. Very simple, right? Now, if it is an Excel sheet, what do you do? First of all, what do you want to do? You want to update a particular data in which particular sheet? You'll go to that particular sheet and what value you want to update for which record, right? So nothing but you have to go to that particular record and that particular column. We are also doing the same thing here. If you observe, this is my Excel sheet. And here what I want to do, I just want to update this particular data, but where? I want to update the first name, but whose first name, right? So I need to go to that particular record. In that particular record, update this particular name, right? Now I'll just execute this command. It will say that how many records it will get updated. One row updated. And you can just perform a commit. Nothing but your control-less kind of logic. And if you read retrieve, now let us re-execute and check out this data should be updated now, right? So this is how you will perform the update operation. Now let us say if you want to delete a particular record. Now let us say I want to delete this particular employee ID 256. I'll just say delete from employees. Which record you want to delete? I'll just say where employee ID is equal to 256. Similarly, if you in Excel sheet, if you want to delete a particular row, how do you do it? You'll not select control here, right? You'll just simply go to that particular row and click on delete. Similarly, what we are doing is I'm saying that I want to delete a row, but which row I want to delete, I'm clearly mentioning here. On what basis, whether employee ID is 256 or 100 or 101, whatever it is, right? I'll just mention, yes, I want to delete this particular row. Similarly, if I want to create a new record now, what I do? So I need to mention insert into employees. So which table I want to insert? Employees table. And what is the data I want to mention? So here, if you observe, if you are not aware of which columns are available, what you do is just mention, I'll just say employee ID, first name, last name, right? So I'll just mention. So it will have its own set of restrictions. Let us say Smith 1, so no, employee ID, right? So employee ID 299, Smith 1, last name. Okay, let's see whether it will allow to insert or not. It says that it cannot insert the data null into email because I have a column called email, where I have a restriction saying that I cannot insert null, right? So I'll just say smith1@gmail.com. Let's try. It says hire date cannot be null. So I need to have hire date also. I'll just mention hire date. I just want to mention sys date. Nothing but current date as my stuff. So job ID also I have to mention. So it is having good amount of restriction on my data. So it all depends upon the database design which you design. So insert. I'll just mention any of the valid job ID so that it will not give me error. Let's try. One more thing it mentioned. Yeah, sorry. It got inserted now here if you observe, right? So now if you just try to re-execute, you should see that particular employee record. Yeah, 299 got inserted now. Okay, so this is not yet saved in the database. It is available only cache level. If you just try to commit it, if you commit it only, it will get persisted in the database. Now let us, if I just click on close it, it will tell you like whether you want to perform a commit changes or not. If you don't perform commit changes, what will happen is whatever it is available, it will be available only at the cache level and it will get rolled off. I mean to say it will get cleared once you, if you don't commit it. Okay. So this is all about high level of database information. Like here, if you observe this employee table is the one which is having employee data. Now let us say if you want to create one more table, just create another table and have the appropriate set of columns. So like who will mention which columns, which data type? See, it all depends upon the business requirement, right? Let us say if you're working for a banking application, you require like a table which table to store your account details, what you have to do is like your business user or a business manager or whoever it is will mention, you know, like I require to design this business application. I require all this particular information to get stored. Then you have to come up with a particular solution saying that, okay, you require this number of columns of this particular data type, which is capable enough to store this information. Okay. So we'll get deeper into like database set of commands in the next session. But in this particular session, we just want to highlight what is data, how it gets stored. Okay. Thank you.